Hey, good morning. So today I am going to discuss about the topic, I'm going to explain the blog summarizer app and function calling and using LLM. So function calling is nothing but in LLMs, whenever you give any query, it is going to give the output in text format. But for any specific use cases, if you want to input this generated text to any other APIs, or if you want to integrate with any other system, the text format is a little bit awkward. So if you get the text format in as in JSON format, it is very feasible to fix it with any kind of application or any API related things. So that is what I'm going to explain today. So first of all, I wanted to explain what is this blog summarizer. So this blog summarizer, app, what it will do, first you have to give the URL. I've created it as an API. For API, you have to give any blog URL as an input. It will give the summarize in 5 points as in JSON output. Usually, if you want to do this one using OpenAI, there is a document associated here to do the function calling, and you have to use this pydantic base model, and then you can do this function call like this, and then it will generate this output as an JSON form. But if you want to use this open API key, it will charge. Without credit in your open API account, we can't do this approach. But without any charging, I have a second approach using Llama API. What it will do, this is the Llama API. I'm using 70B chat model and the Llama API key. You will just give the blog URL, and this is my my prompt to this LLM Llama API. Summarize this link blog in 5 points for creating the YouTube shorts. I just mentioned as an YouTube short. Without this also it will work. So then what I did, generate point schema. I have created one schema where the properties is having a point object, and the type is string, and the description is the description of each point in a given context. That means in a given URL, that is a context, and the given blog URL is the context, and from that it has to pick 5 points from that. And required is a point. So again, what I'm doing is after getting the response, and that response I'm passing it to one more prompt, summarize this content. The response is 5 point summary from the blog, and written as a JSON object array as this schema. I just passed this schema to this prompt, and then I just given that prompt again to the LLM. So what it, the response format, I will show you the output, and again that I'm just extracting the JSON object from the text, then I'm just framing the JSON object and giving it to the API as an output. So see, this is about the code explanation, and now I'm going to demo you the application. So first of all, this is what the blog I have chosen. So I'm going to give this blog to this API as an input. So this one, and then before that I need to start this Flask API. So okay, so this is, the name is changed. I wanted to log summarizer, right? So I want to run this Flask API. I want to start that server. Once it is started, it will take a couple of seconds to start. For a couple of seconds, yeah, it started on the local host. So like I said, you can give the blog link here and then click on send. Then we'll see the link here and it will generate a 5-pointer summary. Using this 5-pointer summary, it will generate a JSON object, and you can see that as an output in the API. So yeah, you can see this one. So this is the generated output, taking this, and then you can format that using the JSON formatter. So each point is a description. So I generated 5-pointer summary out of that block. So you see 5 objects generated. You can use this as an input to put this JSON object as an input to the other API or any other application which you can do for further for your specific use. So yep, this is what I wanted to explain in this video. Any questions, you can comment in the below section. Yeah, and thanks for watching my video. Please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.